Hello, and welcome to the Zero Park onboarding tutorial. This is a beginner's introduction to key Zero Park features. If you're looking for more advanced instructions, you can check out the Zero Park knowledge base. Alternatively, if you have more advanced questions, you can write an email to support@zeropark.com. The goal of this tutorial is to show you how to create campaigns in Zero Park. You will learn about the types of traffic and campaigns available to you in Zero Park while we do a quick overview of the campaign setup procedure. First, to create a new campaign, you should log into your account. Go to the dashboard and click on the New Campaign tab. Select the traffic type. There are three types of traffic available on Zero Park. Each of them has its own way of delivering a visitor and its own price range. Domain traffic. Our domain traffic comes from park domains. This means that when a user misspells a URL in their browser, they get redirected via a 302 redirect to a related landing page. An example could be somebody misspells videostream.com, accidentally missing the V, and typing idiostream.com and hits enter. They are now redirected to a landing page that is associated with the domain videostream. The process is driven by the associated keywords attached to the park domain by the domain owner. Domain traffic can be pricey, but brings you high conversion rates. Premium PPV traffic. This is pop traffic that comes from opt-in adware. A user installs a toolbar in their browser and gives consent to allow pop-ups. In this case, the user types in the correct URL into their browser, videostream.com for example. As they hit enter, a pop-up is triggered, opening a full-sized browser window with a related advert inside. This traffic is URL targeted, so if you wanted video stream traffic, you should use videostream.com as one of the keywords for your targeting. Pop traffic tends to have very high volumes, so it requires quick and fast optimization. In-app traffic. As the name suggests, in-app traffic comes from mobile apps only. It's a perfect way of advertising mobile app downloads. Users can go directly to the relevant app store to download the app after being shown a full screen pop-up on their mobile device. In-app traffic tends to be lower volume but much higher quality as you are targeting users that are already motivated to download. Once you've selected the type of traffic you want, you will need to choose the campaign type. There are four basic campaign types to run on Zero Park. RON. This stands for Run of Network. If you select this option, you will target all available traffic from one specific geo, ignoring URLs and keywords. This is great for when you need high volumes of traffic and quick conversions. Keyword. A keyword campaign allows you to target traffic by related keywords, such as hotels, booking, holidays, or URLs such as agoda.com, booking.com, or expedia.com. This means only sites tagged with or containing these keywords in the URL will be sent to your landing page. If your offer needs a specific audience, this is the campaign for you. Multi-geo. In multi-geo, you'll be able to target multiple countries in the same campaign. Within a multi-geo campaign, you will be presented with two further options, RON or keyword, which work in the same way previously mentioned. Target source. This whitelist campaign category has two campaign types. Note, if you selected in-app traffic, it automatically selects a source campaign as this is the only way to select in-app sources only. Target campaign. A target campaign is the most accurate way to buy traffic, as the sub-ID or target allows you to target one URL from a specific source. The difference between this and a keyword campaign is that a keyword campaign provides one URL from many sources. Source campaign. A source campaign allows you to target all sub-ID from a specific source. If you have an RON campaign and find that some of the sources perform better than others, you can start a source campaign to target the most effective sources. Now you're an expert on the types of traffic and campaigns available, it's time to take you through the basic setup to get you started with your first campaign. We will use a premium PPV RON campaign for this tutorial, as it has the simplest setup. Once you've selected your campaign type, you will need the campaign name. It's best to name it in the same way you do in your tracker, so it's easier for you to find. If you pick pop-up traffic, you will be able to choose inventory type: pre-selected, premium, standard, and remnant. This relates to the quality of the traffic, with premium meaning you are buying from only the best sources. The cost model. If you have access to the Smart eCPA feature, here you can choose between this or the CPM cost model. The Smart eCPA feature requires you to use tracking and send this conversion data back to ZeroPark. Smart eCPA will automatically optimize campaigns to an eCPA goal. To find out more, please contact support at ZeroPark.com. Then you can pick countries, regions, or cities. Once saved, there is no turning back. This is not a mandatory option. If you do not select either, your targeting will be for the country selected. The campaign bid. How much do you want to pay per visitor? The daily budget, to set a limit on your daily spend. The campaign budget, how much do you want the campaign to spend in total? Traffic buying model. If you have a budget specified, you can choose a buying model. You can choose to spend your budget smoothly or more aggressively. If you don't put any budget limit, you cannot specify the buying model. Target's daily budget. How much do you want to spend per target? Source's daily budget. How much do you want to spend per source? Now we can move on to the targeting options. Targeting allows you to optimize your campaign. Let's go over particular targeting settings. Traffic filters. For starters, there are three basic targeting options. Desktop and mobile, targeting all traffic. Desktop only, all desktop traffic. Mobile only, all mobile traffic. If you click to expand the advanced targeting section, you can find more options. To select these, leave the box checked next to the ones you want. Here you can select desired desktop OS versions and browsers, as well as mobile OS versions and, for mobile, the kinds of internet connection. Use the sliders to limit the OS version to the lowest viable OS for your campaign. For example, you can select your campaign to be displayed only on iOS 10 or newer. For mobile only, there's also an option here to choose specific carriers. Click the checkbox next to the carriers you want to receive traffic from. Frequency filters. This setting lets you determine how often you want to show your offer to the same visitor. You can choose to completely turn off the filter and have no restraints in displaying your ads, or make sure that the same visitor won't see it again until a certain number of hours pass. Adult filtering. Here, you can decide if you want traffic from adult web pages or mainstream web pages, or, if the campaign allows, both. Dayparting. This allows you to set your campaign to run at specific hours. If you have a campaign that only works during office hours, you just need to deselect the relevant boxes. After that, it's time to enter your destination URL, the address where you would like to send the traffic. Don't forget to track your conversions. Tracking is the key to a positive ROI. Using the correct setup and tokens can give your campaign a huge advantage, as it will be much easier to optimize and manage. If you're looking for a tracking solution, we recommend Volume, which is the most comprehensive tracker on the market. Additionally, you can easily integrate ZeroPark with Volume to enjoy additional benefits. Volume also offers a 30-day free trial for ZeroPark users. Campaign vertical. You need to specify what type of offer you're promoting, so we can send the best fitting traffic for your campaigns. Then add the information about whether you use a pre-lander and what your cost model is. Finally, select what your campaign status will be once it gets approved by our compliance team. And you're done. The next page will give you a summary of your settings so you can check what you have done. If it's all good, you can then proceed to the dashboard of your shiny new campaign. Let's finish with a couple of tips. If you don't know how big your bid should be, remember that we have a tool for that. ZeroPark.com/volume. As your share of traffic and traffic quality is determined by how much you bid, it's very useful to have something to help you set a starting bid. ZeroPark's Traffic Estimator tool will help you judge the cost of the traffic you're targeting. It allows you to break down available traffic. You can search by desktop, mobile, traffic source, operating system, and adult or non-adult traffic. The tool then displays the country, the volume from that country, and the average cost based on your settings. These numbers are based on historic data from the last 30 days on the platform, so the cost may be a little higher than stated in the estimator, but it's a good starting point. It's smart to set up optimization rules for your new campaign once it's created. If you want to learn more, watch our next video.